Hello friends. In this video, I will teach you how to animate the eyes using smartphones. If you are interested in watching my next tutorials, be sure to press the subscribe button below the video. In this picture, you can see how the eyes and eyelids move using the smartphone. I choose the new option from the file menu and create a new worksheet. I create a new vector layer called IL. I draw a circle for the eye with the draw shape tool. I select the circle with the transform tool. And I make a copy of the circle. We use Ctrl plus C and then Ctrl plus V to copy. By holding the Alt button and dragging from the corner of the shape, I make the copied circle smaller from the center. I make it black. You can use other colors. I create a new vector layer for the eyelid. I create an oval shape above the eye. I choose the color of the skin of the body for the eyelid. I select both eye and eyelid layers and put them in one group. I will change the name of the group to IL. I use a mask to remove the extra parts of the eyelid. I double click on the group and select hide all in the masking settings. In this case, you can see that the extra parts of the eyelid are hidden. I double click on the eyelid layer. The mask this layer option in the masking menu must be active. We activate add to mask for the eye layer. I make the edges of the eyelids thicker using the line width tool. I select the eye group and create a duplicate. In this way, a copy of the eye is created. I write the name of this group as IR for the right eye. Now we have two groups for left and right eyes. Click on the new group. And with the transform tool, I drag the new group layer to the right. I select both groups with the control button and put them in a new group. I click on the new group and change the position of the eyes. Now to create smart bone, I create a bone layer. I put the eyes folder inside the bone layer. Remember, if your character has an original bone, there is no need to create a new bone. The only important thing is that the eye group is inside a layer of bone. I click on the bone layer and create a bone using the Add Bone button. With the Bone Strength tool, I will drag the bone strength to 0. I click on the bone menu and select Make Smart Bone. I change the name of the smart bone to the eye. The minimum and maximum angle of bone movement should be from minus 90 to 90. I set the frame length to 48. And this option must be active. I activate the action section. When the timeline screen is blue, it means that smart bone is active. I select the eye layer with the layer selector tool. I put the slider in frame 48. Now I move the eye with the transform tool. To move directly, hold the shift button. They repeat this for the other eye. In the action section, I double click on mainline. In the action section, I click on I2 and smart bone is activated again. I put the slider on frame 48 again. And I change the place of the eyes. I click on the mainline again. I select the bone layer and test my eye movement. You can see that it is working properly. I will create another bone. I set its power to 0. Smart bone should not be connected to another bone. So I target the connection with the reparent bone tool and left click. Again, from the bone menu and the make smart bone option, I make the same settings as before. I will change its name. This time I move the eyes upwards. I click on mainline again. I select the option OP2 from the action section and apply the changes. I try the eye movement up and down. To open and close the eyes, I create another smart bone and apply its settings as before. The strength of the bone is 0 and not connected to another bone. I choose make smart bone and change the name. I select the slider in frame 48 and the eyelid layer. By selecting the point, I drag it down. I repeat this for the other eye. From the action section, I select eyelid 2 and in frame 48, I create a state of surprise for the eyes. After finishing the settings, I try the movement of the eyes and eyelids. You can see that all the movements are done correctly. To save the project, select Save As from the File menu. We use Import to import the file. Well friends, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. To see the next tutorials, be sure to press the subscribe button below the video. Bye until the next video.